Oh, damn. Oh, damn.
What the hell did he just do?
Welcome!
Anime Lady fans, how you guys doing? LegendDVash
SamTheMangaMan.
And we're here to live react and review Time Cost Bottom for the review Fire Force episode
11.
And we're gonna see some brigade fighting from what I saw on Twitter and being told on social media is some brigade fighting. And we're gonna see the samurai captain fighting.
Benimaru?
Yeah.
Benimaru.
So I'm very excited about that.
Yes. And apparently we're gonna be on break for next 2 weeks of Fire Force.
Yes, guys. Like, so damn. Definitely, guys. If you wanna binge our videos on Fire Force, go ahead and do that because it's gonna be on break for 2 weeks. So we will not be back here with Fire Force content on episode 11.
Episode 12.
October 11th. But you know what's good? Cause the next day after that is My Hero Academia Season 4.
You know what else? Sword Art Online Season 3 Part 2.
Underworld something war.
War of the Underworld.
Yeah, you got it right there.
We got it.
But other than that, let's get straight to it and note that we're gonna be at New York Comic Con the week before Fire Force Episode 12 comes out. So if you're there, we'll see you there. Other than that, guys, come really get thoughts about this episode. What do you guys think about Episode 11? Like the video as well and subscribe if you want more anime content. And thank you very much, guys. Worldly appreciated. Other than that, let's go. Fire Force Benimaru.
It's lit.
And that's an order. I like his blood. Hey, that's an order. You gotta do what you gotta do. So we're about to find the origin story. Nice flag color. I like it.
Oh, that's the lieutenant.
Oh, wow.
He looks. It's just him without glasses and his hat. Oh, that's the captain?
No, that's not the same voice actor. I don't think so.
That's Maki.
The way he speaks is very straightforward and very logical.
Blunt. Really blunt. He's much more blunt than he was in the future. Oh shit. Oh shit, that's messed up. Bro, this is hard.
So he kept his friend's gun. Let's see what his... Definitely his point of view changed now.
Yo, that must hurt though. Your best friend gets turned into... Your partner gets turned into an inferno and you just couldn't pull a trigger. Okay, now there's the captain.
Now we see him.
Okay, so the captain used to be a regular firefighter. He wasn't a fire soldier. They aren't as merciful as the 8th firehouse.
So this is really the origin story of Special 8. They both agreed, so this is where they both became friends. Wow.
But then, like, this is like... Lieutenant just had this experience in front of his face last night, and now he has to go through with this again.
Maybe not same thing, so...
Well, not the same situation, yeah. But he knows how much pain they would be in.
So he's doing the praying, and then the lieutenant is doing the, you know, the putting the soul to rest.
That's funny.
That's pretty cute and funny in a way where, okay, so if you're spending a chess piece, you're the king then.
Also, that's how the 8th Fire Force house came to be.
So he sees it as a goal to save the world and humanity himself. So I wonder how he went to the officials.
Yeah, like how you go on full establishing it. You need like money or people or followers in that sort of way.
And then she's also like, I thought I was here because of my meat.
So we even get the whole first day. But how did Irish join in though?
Was dressing all white?
The seventh shirt, Benimaru. Okay, so from the whole Western world, he lives in the Eastern world, which is like Japan. Oh, come on, it's a sweet old granny.
So his eyes is a cross and a target. That's pretty cool. Mm. Do you know what his town and place and himself reminds me of? Like Itachi and Uchiha's clan right there.
In a way. He gets ticked off really easy. He's like Shikamaru. Like, yeah, is this a drag?
Yeah.
Damn.
Damn, that's blunt. Oh, twins. Wait, twins?
Yeah, twins.
Hinata, that's pretty cute. A lot of Naruto reference right now we having. At least he knows him very well, saying that, hey, you don't want to confront, so we come here. Pretty blunt, straightforward. It's my turn for you to acknowledge me. Then I'll definitely talk big. Let's see if it happens.
Reminds me of Promare when he had that staff, that weapon. Oh, damn. Oh, damn!
What the hell did he just do?
Yeah, he just picked up another one. Okay, he's using like a flying broom right there.
I'm so lost here right now.
Very lost. Okay, he has 5 of them.
Does he control them or something? I'm so confused. And he's doing a lot of property damage.
Come on, like, property damage. What if people were living in these homes? Damn, with those matois.
Maybe that's the difference of his eyes. One's controlling, one is doing them.
Bro, he just put his hand in there and just burn them like this?
He didn't even do a prayer either.
Yeah, no prayer, no nothing. But that's such a heavy burden, though.
No wonder the way he is like that, because he feels he has so much pressure and like...
So much responsibility.
Well, that's the end of the live reaction of episode 11.
Five Force, you mean?
Yeah, Five Force.
Not so here.
Yeah.
But yeah, this was a good episode, honestly, especially the first part when the establishment of Firehouse Company 8.
We got the origin story of Firehouse 8, and I like it.
It got emotional way in the beginning.
Because
right
now we know why the lieutenant is the way he is with guns. Mm-hmm. Why he takes it so serious, and why he takes his job of his so serious.
But he was also hesitate the first time, like, I don't need your gun, and like...
Because you're killing your best friend!
Well, he didn't know he was gonna kill his best friend. His gun was baptized, his gun wasn't, and then when you come to the point where he turns to an inferno, like...
He said, well, you'd rather be shot by a gun that's not baptized or unbaptized. Like, damn.
And it's like, shit, and like, we see the difference between unbaptized gun and a baptized gun. Apparently, it takes many bullets for an unbaptized gun, but with a baptized gun, it's just one shot, and... Done. It's over. It go, get rest in peace now.
But I wonder.
But it sucks though because he's best friend. He's your partner, and you couldn't save him from that, and you hesitated. But I get it though, because his gun is not baptized. He's gonna suffer even more if you're gonna like just regularly shoot him like this. But it sucks. That's like a heavy heart to
a huge
soul.
Burden. So I felt bad for Lieutenant, but he did move forward and grew stronger as a person.
Literally the next
But then,
day.
The next following time, he went out and on patrol or just taking a stroll
he
in the city.
Stroll, yeah.
And he met Obi. And Obi and
he
him
was like
had,
a regular firefighter. And that was like, wow, okay, so... He, and before fire soldier, he went before whole training and everything.
Yeah.
This guy
and now, but I wish we got to find out how did he repel the paper. Yes, like
establishing it.
Yeah, like I wonder how did he go to the higher ups and everything. So I really want to know more about the backstory. Mm-hmm. Hopefully, we do get that. But to actually understand that, and then Maki joined because she's like, oh my god, you talk so nice about me!
She was recommended by the second soldier, and like, we've seen it, and he explained it. She does twice the work if she does the weight. She does twice as everything, she needs to move better. But thing is that she's not great as a soldier because her father is like a lieutenant. Reminds me of Lois Lane in a way.
Yeah, it's very true, and also remind me of Zuko and her sister.
Mm-hmm.
That they were like they have the unbalance because the sister had the
always
lightning
be
and everything better,
and
Zuko had the fire. But also, I want to know more the backstory of how Iris joined as well because we got Mikey.
Well, we
so,
know how her story came in, like her own church got burned.
Yeah,
up,
but we don't know how she got into
the
8th division.
Indigen,
So I want to know more about that. So that's pretty cool. I want to know more of the in-between of how the 2-year time skip about how Obi, you know, went up to the higher ranks. I want to know about that.
I want to also
but that's
know
another
like
in
the
future.
Whole messed up fire, the point system shit. I was like, yo, that's a
and Death Division
up.
3.
And
so
like,
hopefully we get to know more about him.
Why the whole point system? You're trying to put out the fire, you're giving him mercy.
But
him
then it brings
like,
back to why Obi told Arthur and Shinra about the axe and his sword
to hide your weapon.
So it makes more sense of why Obi's like that.
And it's so messed up where like that firehouse lieutenant captain for the dirt house is like, yo, we don't even care about it. We gotta go for the one for the pursuit. And you don't go for the undoctrined man that just sitting there like trying to hold back and just getting some mercy killing and stuff like that.
Yeah, so it makes sense.
It is messed up.
And now we also see Benimaru and his way of his town's village on why they like that and the way he is. It makes all sense.
But it's so
and like you
heavy
said,
though. Like,
it's a huge responsibility for a man to actually
like
hold up
all
that
of them,
much
it
in
seems
your shoulders.
Like this whole entire townspeople kind of gave up hope in a way, and like we know we might turn to inferno, and we know we're not in the best area, so we're going to die anyway. We'd rather have Benimaru to
and,
kill us.
And instead of a prayer,
and
he destroys
like,
the houses and the neighbor hood around him to wear the inferno. So that's a lot of burden to take up.
Like, these are like nice,
it makes
friendly
sense,
people, and like I really hope this doesn't happen. Like I don't want the grandma to turn into an inferno.
I was thinking about that too. Like yo,
oh
grandma,
God,
you better
please
not turn to inferno throughout the series. I feel bad if
that's,
you do.
That's gonna hurt Benimaru so much more and shit. It's like you know I never liked these, but it was a nice treat to receive them. And now
all the
I'm
time
not,
and say
I'm
it's
not
too
getting
sweet
them anymore. It's like oh my God.
But
the shit that he
to see
to
the town people like that, it makes sense. And also to not make sense, well, our theory is why he has just two different color eyes. It's because one is for controlling and one is for actually creating the flames. So it makes total sense.
Honestly, I don't think he has any involvement with the Assassin's Creed, Evangelist people. In a
oh
way.
No, he don't.
He has too much of a burden right now.
But
I mean,
he don't really care about it because he just worries about his people
and
the town.
Because he had to, in this point of view, he can't care. The moment he cares, it's gonna hurt him all at once in his fort.
That could be true.
Because you have to numb he has to numb himself of all the action.
That's why he doesn't want to believe the people become infernals by actually become people. That's why he probably don't want to believe it. Because if that's true, that means that's the way to stop it. That's him actually putting himself and his feelings out there more.
And that's so sad.
Wow.
Like, oh my god, I feel so bad. It explains why he's the mightiest. A Fire Force soldier, though. He can control two different kinds of abilities, second generation and third generation powers. But yeah, man, that's a heavy burden.
It is. It makes sense why he's so powerful and why he's very respected by his lieutenant and the people. And it makes sense. But we made a lot of reference, and those were his kids or it's just his family?
I think it's just part of his family. But that's another thing, too. I don't see many of his, many people in his team and his crew.
Yeah, all those people that was throwing him those brooms.
I thought they were just part of the people that lives there.
Those were his squad.
Huh, interesting.
But it was pretty cool the way they dress and also the way those brooms are really interesting. They just throw them on.
Those are like the old school Japanese firefighters. They used to use these matois to fight fires and then use them to fight fires with their bare hands. Same way with Promare and like the guy action uses.
By the way, guys, if you haven't checked out Promare or check it out. It's very fun. So definitely do that. Anything else to say, Sam?
Oh my god, it was a good episode. I don't know if I can wait 2 weeks.
3 weeks, definitely. We're gonna be strong. We're gonna be stronger than James because he's reading it. So we're gonna be strong. We have other content to do this. So definitely, hopefully, you guys watch the other content you guys do. And now continue to enjoy our Fire Force only content you guys enjoy. So comment down below your thoughts about this episode. What do you guys think about it? Did you feel emotional? Did you understand about Benimaru? Are you reading the manga as well? Let us know down in the comment section below. Join the Discord server as well. Like the video as well. And subscribe if you want more anime lately content. Follow us on social media. See you at New York Comic Con. And see you in 3 weeks for episode 12 on October 11th.